women have to be proactive in their career. We have to get ourselves noticed at the beginning of our careers. We just can't sit around pretty and wait for that promotion to come to us. Granted, businesses are now seeking to put women in the forefront. One such company is EABL. 30% of the board members are women. And I know you're probably thinking, that's not a lot, but think about it. How many women are on your board? Let's do a head count. One, two, three, none. Kenya Breweries Limited, Managing Director John Musunga is a believer in diversity and gender equality and is turning business around by bringing more women on board across all levels of business, from graduate trainees to the board. Let's hear what he has to say.
My name is John Musunga and I'm Managing Director at Kenya Breweries Limited, a Diageo company. So for us at KBL, celebrating life every day, everywhere, is our purpose. And actually, celebrating diversity really speaks to that purpose, that as human beings, we are no different from one another, and therefore, diversity for us is a strength and not a weakness. So let me give you a few examples of how we've tried to embed diversity and inclusion in our business. For one, if you look at our board composition at the very top, 30% of our board members are female. And that's a deliberate action for us that we've done over time. If you go down to the bottom of the organization, we have a STEM program where we're encouraging graduates in science, in technology, in engineering, and in mathematics to come into our business in different areas, particularly in our supply chain organization, and learn skills and capabilities which enable them to become the technical and professional experts that they've studied in school to do. If you look at our value chain, we have 47,000 farmers across Kenya. 50% of those are women. And therefore, by empowering these women in their communities, we feel strongly that we are empowering society in Kenya at large. Because as we know in our African setting, women are really the backbone of our communities. Another example in our value chain is that we recently, and in partnership with Sightsavers have committed to working to include people with disabilities in our value chain, particularly in the agriculture setting. And we started with a group of 71 farmers in a county in Kenya called Homa Bay. We integrated these farmers at the time when COVID was a real menace, and therefore made them productive in their communities. We are expanding this further and partnering with Sightsavers to try and include people with disabilities in our business, and that's an endeavor that we've just started, and hopefully in the next few months we should see a few of those in our ecosystem, and also assist them with training and capability building. In our commercial organization, we had a program recently where we recruited 10 graduates, all women, integrating them into our business, and hopefully some of those will eventually join our mainstream business and thrive in our environment. So overall as a business, we are committed to ensuring that we are a diverse and inclusive organization, not only in gender, but in disability, in any area where we feel that we need to include people who are minorities or disadvantaged. I think in our business, we view diversity as an enabler to enable our business to grow and thrive. So it's not something we take for granted or something we do to tick a box. And that's why, particularly in our supply chain organization and the commercial organization, where we had a disproportionate amount of male in our communities, we've taken deliberate efforts to rebalance that so that we bring in that diverse individual, the lady, the person with disabilities, so that then we form a thriving community that speaks to the diversity that we have in our communities here in Kenya. At KBL, we believe that if we do not include women in our communities, we become lesser. We do not get the requisite composite views of everybody, and therefore make the right business decisions for us and for our communities. So I think it is not a good to have, it is a must do that we include women, that we include others with a different view and opinion into the organization so that we thrive. And I think one of the things that really makes us proud is that we've made a lot of effort in the organization efforts that have been recognized with a number of awards in our community. I don't think we are working because of the awards, but just having that recognition, I think, is a good thing for us in the business, and it's a good thing for other business leaders in Kenya to think about diversity and inclusion. So I don't take it for granted that I have an opportunity to speak with worthy business leaders like you today. And so therefore, I want to challenge you all to really think diversity and inclusion as an opportunity to enable your business grow, thrive in your communities, in your countries. So I challenge you all, please consider diversity and inclusion as a must-have and not a good to-do.